As an advanced medical practitioner and pharmacist practicing in family medicine, more and more patients are always asking me, are these aluminium salts in antiperspirants safe to use? So please stick around. We're about to dive into the science, learn about aluminium salts exactly, if they're dangerous. And also we're going to discuss these aluminium-free deodorants that we're seeing everywhere in grocery stores and if they actually work. So let's begin. Okay, so first things first, what is the difference between a deodorant and an antiperspirant? So I'm going to make this very simple. Deodorants control odor. They don't stop you from sweating. So basically, because they're not reducing the sweating, they're not going to reduce the bacterial load either. So they're not really going to help stop the cause of the smell. Antiperspirants, on the other hand, reduce sweating. They contain active ingredients, which we call aluminium salts, and they temporarily plug our sweat glands and basically reduce the amount of sweat we produce. So this basically means less moisture, less sweat, which also equals less bacteria, which also equals less smell. Also, just a quick note, for something to be called an antiperspirant, it must have an active ingredient that basically blocks those sweat glands and reduces sweating. So for example, when you're in the grocery store and you see aluminium-free deodorant, aluminium-free this and that, basically, if it doesn't contain aluminium, it's not gonna block the sweat, therefore it cannot be called an antiperspirant. So please do not be fooled by this marketing spin. It's basically just an air freshener, if you wanna call it that. Now, a great example of a clinical strength antiperspirant, for example, are our SweatBlock maximum clinical protection wipes and our SweatBlock maximum clinical protection roll-on. These both contain aluminium chloride, which is a very potent aluminium salt, and one application can give up to 7 days of protection. These are what we call our stronger clinical strength product range. Basically, you apply them at night time and you apply them once a week because they're so potent. You can also then in the morning apply our SweatBlock clinical protection deodorant and antiperspirant stick as you would do normally. This will also help block the sweat glands and temporarily reduce the amount of sweat that you have. So this one in my hand contains a less potent aluminium salt, so you can use it daily, and it's a much longer name. It's aluminium zirconium tetrachlorohydrex GLY. So because it's less potent, you can use it daily and smell fresh at the same time. So I guess the next question is, what's the deal with these aluminium-free deodorants? I mean, is aluminium salts, are they dangerous? Well, let's find out. So I take it, just like me, you've either walked into a grocery store or you walked into a pharmacy, let's say, and you've gone to the deodorant antiperspirant section and you're noticing sticks similar to this and they say aluminium-free deodorant. And it's almost branded in a certain way that because it's aluminium-free, it's safe. So I guess the first question is, where did this fear come from? Over the past couple of decades, there's been a lot of rumors spreading about aluminium salts and their increased risk of breast cancer and Alzheimer's, for example. And these claims generated a lot of traction without much scientific proof. So when it comes to aluminium, it's actually one of the most abundant elements on Earth. It's found naturally in our food, in our water. So we consume small amounts in everyday foods like potatoes, like our tea that we drink, leafy greens. So I guess the question is, when you apply an antiperspirant with aluminium salts in it, how much is being absorbed? Well, studies actually showed that less than 0.012% of aluminium is actually absorbed through your skin. And by the way, to put that into perspective, that is a tiny amount, far less than you're actually taking orally through food and water. So the next question is, what about the cancer concerns? So in the early 2000s, some research speculated that aluminium could be absorbed through the skin and affect estrogen levels in breast cells. And since estrogen plays a role in breast cancer, the theory was that these antiperspirants with aluminium, but here's the truth, no solid scientific evidence has ever proven this risk. In fact, a 2014 review in Critical Reviews of Toxicology found no correlation between aluminium-based antiperspirants and breast cancer. And a large epidemiological study compared 800 women with breast cancer and 800 women without, found zero connection between aluminium salt-based antiperspirants and the risk of breast cancer. Also, the American Cancer Society, the National Cancer Institute, and the FDA all agree that there is no link between these antiperspirants and breast cancer. Now, another concern that you might have heard about with aluminium-based antiperspirants, this one's not as popular as the breast cancer myth, but it is an increased risk of Alzheimer's. This stems from a study done back in the 1960s, where they found high levels of aluminium within the brains of patients with Alzheimer's. However, later research debunked this, as they found that these aluminium deposits were as a result of the disease, not the cause of it. The Alzheimer's Association and the World Health Organization have both stated that there is no conclusive evidence linking aluminium exposure and Alzheimer's disease. So if you're using an antiperspirant with an aluminium salt, you don't need to worry about a breast cancer risk or Alzheimer's disease. Now, whilst we're talking about aluminium, I really want to go into more detail on aluminium salts. So you might have heard of like aluminium chloride. These ones of our products, the Roll and the White by SweatBlock, they contain aluminium chloride. This is a very potent aluminium salt. And you might have also heard of things like aluminium sesquichlorohydrate, or like in our deodorant and antiperspirant stick by SweatBlock, this one contains aluminium zirconium tetrahydrochlorex GLY. It's a very hard one to say. So what do we mean by these salts? It basically means compounds formed when aluminium reacts with other elements, such as chlorine or oxygen, basically making it more stable. So like I said, aluminium chloride, it's the most potent aluminium salt, and it's in our SweatBlock wipes and in our SweatBlock roll-on, the clinical strength ones. And they're generally applied once a week, and it'll last for about 7 days. So because they're potent, we apply them once a week and at night time. The aluminium chloride, because it's more potent, it does sometimes cause a bit more sensitivity compared to the less potent aluminium salts, so it's always good to do a little patch test before using it. Now, for daily use antiperspirants, for example, our SweatBlock clinical protection antiperspirant and deodorant, the one in my hand, this contains a less potent aluminium salt, so remember the long name, aluminium zirconium tetrachlorohydrex GLY. Because it's less potent, it's generally better tolerated and causes less sensitivity, so you can use it every single day. And so you can use it in combination with aluminium chloride. Obviously, the aluminium chloride, like the SweatBlock wipes, for example, you'd use that at nighttime once a week, and then in the day you'd use our SweatBlock clinical protection antiperspirant and deodorant in my hand. And also a pro tip that I always like to tell everyone and all my patients: with any aluminium salt containing antiperspirant, it's always best to use on clean, dry skin. Basically, if your skin is wet with water, it can increase sensitivity with any aluminium salt, so it's really important to apply it on dry skin. Also, especially with aluminium chloride, please do not apply it straight after going to the shower. Your pores are open, your skin's warm, it's going to cause a lot more sensitivity. So this one really needs to be on cool, dry skin. So I really do hope that you found this information helpful. You now know about the safety profile of aluminium containing antiperspirants, and also what the real difference is between aluminium containing antiperspirants and basically aluminium free deodorants. And basically, that if you're using an aluminium free deodorant, like I said earlier, it's basically an air freshener. It's not going to stop you from sweating, so it doesn't really help with sweat patches or odor. I really hope that you found this information helpful. If you know anyone that would also find the information helpful, please do share it with them. SweatBlock is a game changer when it comes to excessive sweating. As a US-based company, we offer FDA-approved solutions for excessive sweating. Our journey started in 2004 when Dr. Scott Steffensen, a renowned researcher, basically developed our original sweat wipes, actually to address his own sweating issues. Today, SweatBlock is the number one clinical strength antiperspirant sold online, helping hundreds and thousands of people regain confidence. Visit our website and Amazon links in the description below to learn more about our product range. And as we always say at the end of the video, SweatBlock, sweat less, live more.